Namaskar to all. Myself, Dr. Shivakant Patel, here with you. Welcome all of you in laboratory of truth, justice, and dharma. And after doing this, I feel your presence in my soul. Your presence insists me to be in relation with you. Today, I will be with you a new lecture of Human Value Vedanta Darshan. So we are directly going through the lecture. So we are in one more lecture, that is lecture number 16 of Human Value in Sankhya, Yoga and Vedanta Darshan. And in this lecture, we will discuss about Upada, Anupada, right, wrong feeling, suchita, asuchita, that is pure and impure, reason for raga, desire and liking. So, moving towards the lecture. So, discussion is here begun from topic upadha, anupadha. Right, wrong feeling. To explain the upadha and anupadha, here is a sutra 6.2.3. This formula speaks chaturastram maya upadha. Anupadhascha chaturascha maya upadha anupadhascha. Whatever activities, the meaning of this sutra is, whatever activity we are doing, whatever karma is doing in the four ashrams, this four ashram here in the Vedanta Darshan is divided into four age groups. First ashram 0 to 25 year, 25 to 50 year, 50 to 75 year, and 75 to 100. So four ashrams may have fault. If there is fault and problem in the activity, then it is called upadha. If there is no problem and fault, by doing a specified activity or suggested activities is called anupadha. So first of all, be clear about the term upadha and anupadha. Anupadha may not have problems and fault, and anupadha may have faults when all the specified and suggested activities done in all four ashrams. Now, to explain in more simple way, we want to see the formula number 6.2.4. Bhav dosh, fault in bhav. Dosh in bhav. Bhav dosh, upadha, dosho, nupadha. Dosho, nupadha. dosh plus anupada. Upada, like or absence of bhav, incorrect bhav, means when we are doing some any physical activity without any bhav in body, are incorrect bhav, improper bhav, then this is called upada. Upada, if the example is this, if we do the meditation and this meditation is only to see from another person, we are showing that I am doing the meditation, but it is not with the real bhav of meditation, then it is called upada. If we are doing some social services only for showing the people that I am a social worker, then it is upada. Doing work with correct, proper, pure bhav, then it is called anupada. After explaining upada and anupada, we are going to see suchita and asuchita, pure, impure. To explain suchita and asuchita, see the Sutra 6.2.5 of Vaisheshika Darshan, Vaisheshika philosophy. It is yadi rupa ras gandha asparsh prochitam abhyuchitam cha takshuchi. It means this formula explain what is the suchita. Suchita, which is our liking, ichha, desire, clean, hygienic. One thing, if any either substance, object, or any ideology is neat, clean, and hygienic, any desire, liking, then it is called suchita. We do a lot of activity, a lot of type of relations we are keeping with the different persons. Different persons, we are taking the different type of behavior, work. Right? There is no very specific reason for priority or preferences. So in that condition, one should give proper importance to that preference. It should not be ignored. Then it is the number category of suchita. Now we want to see the asuchita. In the Vaisheshik Darshan, it is given in the formula 6.2.6. Asuchi, suchi prati sedha. Suchita is just opposite, asuchita is just opposite of suchita. Means where suchita is liking, icha, clean, hygienic, then we may say that which is not of our liking, not clean, not hygienic, then it's called asuchita, pure, impure. Purity in logic, purity in bhav, neatness in bhav, neatness if it is object in object. Now, see, this terminology suchita and asuchita can also be explained in more scientific way by taking two more sutras, three sutras. The sutra number 6.2.7 is Athantaram cha. Whatever meaning of suchita is explained, there is no alternate meaning. There is no other meaning aspect of Suchita, then the definition which is given just before this, which is our liking, clean, hygienic. In formula 6.2.8, it is given here that ayatasya suchi bhojana dabhyu dayona vidyate niyama bhavad vidyate vasthantar twadi yamasya. Formula 6.2.9 speaks asati chabhava. This both formula speaks if the previous aspects of Suchitas are restored in true sense. What is previous aspects of Suchita? Ichha, which is our liking, clean and hygienic. If any things of this category is restored in true sense, in right aspects, it will become impure. Asuchi, if the yama, ahimsa, sat, asat, brahmachar, aparigri is not added. If seen carefully, suchita is ensured in our three senses. We have done very well, but we have not considered ahimsa, sat, asatya, brahmachar, aparigra. Then it is not a suchita, then it is not related with the suchita. If we accept niyam, yam niyam, sans, santos, tap, svadhyay, iswar, pranidhan are not added to, it will be ensured abhyuddha. Is acceptable if niyams are not adhered to, it will be ensure abhyuddha. Now see, why desire like rag, reason for rag, and this reason for rag is given by the three formula here. The formula number is 6.2.10. Sukha dagra. Sukha dagra. Rag means desire and liking is outcome of sukha. When we feel sukha, if we are happy, then by that whatever comes out, it is called rag. Means sukh and rag are interrelated. Sutra 6.2.11 speaks tanmay tvachya, which speaks that what is happiness. Happiness means in reverence, in peace, pleasure, in happiness. Thinking, reading, listening about the pleasure, all time. It is a desire and liking of a person. Every time, thinking, reading, listening, feeling, want to be in a state of always pleasure, happiness, in continuity. The Sutra 6.2.12, Astas Tachi. Astras Adrast. Because of past samskar, maybe in previous life, this desire and liking may be linked with the past life. Here are the basic guidelines is given to be in the state of, see carefully here, upada, anupada, suchita, asuchita, rag, desire and liking. So for that, say the sutra 6.2.13, it speaks jati visesarchi. Jati means specified category. Due to jati oblique body, natural inclination due to body construction will be inclined on some other person due to see its shape, size, and color, and gender. Liking due to similar woman, woman, Indian, Indian, Hindu, Hindu, Muslim, Muslim, etc. like this. Liking is due to, and liking is due to dissimilarity. Sutra 6.2.14, Ichha Dvesh Purvika Dharma Dharmayoh Praviti. All of our inclination for dharma, and dharma is due to Ichha, Rag and Dvesh. This formula is very important. This formula speaks that whatever activity of dharma and other we are doing, or whatever our inclination is, our liking is towards dharma or other, it is only due to our ichcha, vichara and asana. Here ichcha, rag and dvesh. Formula 6.2.15 speaks tat sanyogo vibhaga. Tat sanyogo vibhaga. See birth. What is birth? Coming of atma, intermingling of atma to body is due to dharma and adharma. A particular soul will be intermingling with which type of body is depend upon his activity done in the past. Dharma and adharma. Tat sanyogo vibhaga. And the formula 6.2.16. Here is Atma Guna Karmasu Moksho Vyakhyata. Atma Guna Karmasu Moksho Vyakhyata. Here for the liberation it is given. How we can be free, liberate, Karmananda ki prapti, realization of coexistence. Karmas keeping in mind, karmas means activities, keeping in mind of good of Atma will result in it. If you want to keep our Atma neat and clean, away from all type of wrong activities, immoral activities, illegal activities, will give path of liberation. That is the moksha, attainment of moksha, attainment of liberation. See, here it is required to think these questions here related to dharma. How can one say be dharmic? Who is dharmic? Person who is dressed in a particular way, particular type, Hindu methodology, different type of Bhagavad dress, Muslim, different type of this dress, Christian different, Sikh different, etc. So we dress decide the person is dharmic or not, or any other factor is there. Person who is having choti or sikha, Brahmins, one who keeps choti or head is dharmic. See a particular question. A person has a right sentiment, right work, suchita, upadhana, and whatever the terminology is given in the positive aspect, one has. then he is a dharmic or not. Now it is required to see every one of us. See, in this lecture, we are in the end of Vaisheshika Darshan. Up to the lecture, we have completed Nyaya Darshan and Vaisheshika Darshan. Thereafter, we will start Yoga Darshan. For the upliftment of soul. This is only in the present selection, but it is not least last. We are in process of continually meeting with each other. At last, once more, Sabhi ko namaskar.